Good morning students, in this video we will discuss the explanation part of lesson number 3, the wheat is cheaper. So here's the conversation between Ravi, Ashok and David. They were the three boys and here the conversation is given over there. Ravi and Ashok, they were the good friend and they went to see David Smith, who is the son of an Englishman who traveled widely and now his father working in India. Ravi and Ashok met few days before David, but now they all three boys becomes the good friend. So now the conversation start. What happened? One day David asked Ravi to tell him some good Indian story. He asked Ravi to tell him good Indian story. Then Ravi said, okay, I will tell you one of the story which I had heard from my grandfather. He heard from his grandfather because his grandfather used to tell him stories every night. Then Ashok asked what the story. Then Ravi said, wheat is cheaper. David said, wheat is cheaper. Cheaper than what? Then Ravi said, let me tell you the story. Then I will let me tell you the story. Then you decide how the wheat is cheaper. So then he started. There lived a greedy merchant. There lived a merchant who was very greedy. He used to go to town to buy or sell large quantities of grain. And even on his way to this town, he started of thinking and thought of making money, how he will get more and more money. So what happened one day when he was going to a town to buy some grain, what did he notice? He saw a farmer there at some distance. Here he thought that it's a very good opportunity to get some money out of this simple villager. So he walked quickly to him and asked him to be a good friend. He asked him to be a good friend and be a companion to him. Then the farmer replied, how could I become a good companion to you, because I am a simple villager and you are the merchant. How could I haven't seen much in this world, a lot of in this world, and then how could I be a good friend to you? Then merchant was very greedy and he was very cunning and he is saying, no, we both become a good companion, so let us have a deal. He proposed that they should enjoy each other's company. The farmer told him that he was too unsuitable to prove the merchant a good companion. The merchant told the farmer that they would both tell a tale. What did he say? That they would both tell a tale to each other. And what did he say? He said to the farmer that I will pay you 100 rupees. That I will pay you 100 rupees if I cast doubt on your story. And if you cast doubt on my story, you pay me 100 rupees. Then the farmer agreed and the bargain was struck. The merchant began to tell the story first, because it's the merchant turn and he is thinking that he is the simple villager, so I will be able to earn 100 rupees very easily. Then he started. What he said? One day he saw a merchant with a long train of camel. He saw a merchant with a long train of camel, and each of the camels was loaded with large quantities of grain. And all the camels were tied together with ropes, nose to tail. Just then a kite flew down. What happened? Just then a kite flew down on the first camel. Then what happened? All the camels were carried by the kite. As a first camel, on the first camel, the kite was flew down and all the carried were tied along with them. So all the camels were also carried up with the kite. Then what happened? The farmer said, it must have been a very strong kite. What did he say? Yeah, it may be possible. It is. It must be very strong kite that it flew down all the camels. So then what happened? The merchant failed to get any money. He is thinking, why he is not casting doubt on my story. Then therefore he tried to make another attempt. What did he say? He told a princess sitting in her garden. What did he say? That a princess was sitting in her garden and her maid was combing her hair. The maid of the princess was combing the hair of the princess. The princess looked up and saw that the kite was flying up in the sky. And what happened then? The kite was flying in the sky just above her head and with the train of camel. Just then what happened? That princess was seeing above. So what happened? Then the train of camel fell down into the princess's left eye. The princess started crying. Why she started crying? Because it's a severe pain when the lots of camel fall down on her eye. That is almost 101 camel. Her maid lifted her eyelid. Then what happened? Her maid lifted her eyelids and removed all 101 camels, one after the other from her eye. So that's the story. Later she put all the camels in her pocket. So one more attempt the merchant tried. That farmer may cast doubt on his story. What did he say? That the maid put up all the 101 camels from the eye of princesses to her pockets. The farmer again didn't cast any doubt on the story told by the merchant, and hence the merchant failed to get any money from the farmer and he got disappointed. So that's the story.